Now, that out of the way. While we're talking on the subject of football, let's talk about sports in general. A long time, I mean, I went through it as well, the idea that you should or need to put your kid into sports for the sake of that that's where they're going to learn teamwork, that's where they're going to learn leadership and like stick-to-itiveness and drive. That's where they're going to learn these kind of character traits. And they probably do learn those things in those features. But I don't know if it's an ideal place for them to learn those things. I think you can learn teamwork and like leadership and like planning and all that cooperation, communication skills. You can learn all those things in, let's say, a Dungeons and Dragons party. You can learn those things in World of Warcraft server. You can learn those things, like there are other places that you can learn those things. Decathlon, maybe. Like, you can learn stuff like that. You can learn those things at work. Get a job, you'll have to learn discipline and following directions and learning how to ask questions and stuff. Just as easily as you could learn those in sports. But from my experience with sports, and I think that most people's experience with sports, is that you don't see a lot of people learning like how to depend on others. But I do have seen a lot of people learning how to swell their own egos and to overestimate the value of personal kind of personal contributions. And what I mean by that specifically, before you come at me, is the idea that how to estimate how much different people have contributed to a goal. Because the linemen in the NFL and the wide receivers and the running back and the tight ends and the quarterback, they contributed 1/11th of the sweat into a specific play, right? Generally. But who contributed the most? The touchdown is going to go to whoever was carrying the ball across the field, or across the breaking the plane. Or if, like, let's say they aired it out, it's going to go to the quarterback. You're not going to see anyone that's a left tackle credited with a touchdown very often. And when they do, it's usually because it's a busted play. But simply, it's one of the reasons why a lot of there are certain people that prefer defense, because it seems like it's more of an individual contributive sort of that, like, they count things like batted balls and broken up passes and things like that in a lot more strict way than just blocks or successful run at like lanes that have been opened by you. But what I'm getting at is, like, I don't know how many people, grown men that I've met throughout my life, that were fixated, and it's a little bit of a cultural stereotype, the guy that is fixated on his performance on the field in high school or college, and then so many that they got hurt, let's say, in high school or college, and they could have gone pro. And so now they put all this overwhelming pressure on their kids that you need to go pro, because that's my dream. You could say, like, his name, LeVar Ball, is that guy. Dude that got cut from his college team because he averaged 3 points a game, claiming that he was better than Michael Jordan, who was averaging 20-plus points a game at the professional level at that same time. Like we see that sports really feeds ego. It also has the tendency to kind of delude a person into believing things about achievement that aren't necessarily true. That wins and losses are about points on the board, or that progress is singular in direction, that you're moving the ball forward, or you're losing. And that's not really true about life either. That in fact, actually, sometimes you got to take several steps backwards in order to make a real meaningful step forward in life. Sometimes you have to say no to an opportunity here so that you can grow here, right? And that's what life is really like. And I think sports don't really build those kind of intangibles in a very effective way. I think that they tend to distract from the academic nature of school. Like, I mean, so many just historically documented instances of athletes being given free passes on their underperformance in athletics because they can dribble a ball well, or because they can make plays on the grass. And that's not necessarily healthy either, because it's an entitlement mindset present there, as well as the entitlement mindset present in that if you make it pro, you get free stuff given to you all the time, even though they have the means to buy it themselves. Here, endorse our product, we'll give it to you for free. Like, it creates that entitlement, that insular mindset that, I mean, quite frankly, you have this very, very, very small portion of society that is just undeniably pedestaled up, and you can see it rot them. Of that, you have stories like just so many athletes that make it to college and then get cut because their grades aren't there, and because drugs. And you give somebody that has terrible intangibles, terrible sense of self and self-esteem and self-worth, you give that person a high platform, they're only going to they're gonna squander it with sex, drugs, rock and roll, right? They're going to end up not using it effectively. And so you have, like, Charles Barkley, I'm not a role model, parents are role models, to try and diffuse some of that energy put towards them. But what I'm getting at, most of all, is that if you want your kid to learn leadership, discipline, teamwork, the best place for you to learn those things is at home. And that the gridiron, the basketball court, the baseball diamond, those are good laboratories for what you've learned at home. And that if at home you're teaching your kid to be selfish and self-interested and to prioritize their personal achievement and their personal statistics over the success of your household, when they get out there onto that baseball diamond, they're going to exhibit those traits. And you know what's really tragic? Is that those laboratories, the football field, the basketball court, the baseball diamond, the hockey rink, they will let those toxic traits succeed. And because, quite frankly, you can succeed as a kind of prima donna wide receiver. You can succeed as selfish people in sports, but you cannot succeed as a selfish person in life.